This is the Friday edition with your correspondent, Melanie Chartoff.
Good evening. I'm Melanie Chartoff, and these are tonight's top stories. A message was just received from Poland by ham radio operators in the United States. The message came in the form of a riddle. How many soldiers does it take to screw the Polish people? The answer was 258,000. One to order martial law and 257,999 to enforce it. In the news from Washington this week, due to fears raised by the threat of a Libyan hit squad, the White House announced today that starting immediately, President Reagan will no longer appear either in public or in private. For security reasons, he will evidently be kept in a secret, sealed-off chamber with no light, sound, food, or water. Other than that, the president's daily routine will remain the same. In other news, following a study by the Sloan Kettering Institute in New York, the government is requiring that a warning be placed on all mistletoe sold in the United States. The studies say the scientists involved has established a link between mistletoe and mononucleosis. Oh, I'm sorry. This just handed to me. Small, slimy, crab-like aliens from the planet Neptune did not land in the vicinity of Fresno, California last night. Residents are not being urged to wear tartan plaid tam o'shanters, which scare the aliens, and have not been told to stock up on silly putty, which the aliens can't figure out. A sad note. Santa Claus died early this morning. Evidently, old St. Nick was reputed to have passed on from an overdose of methadrine at his workshop in the Arctic Circle. More of the Friday edition right after this.
This is the national hit team of Libya. They are well-trained and eager. They are committed to their goals. They have traveled many miles to complete their work in the United States. But they may not get a chance to finish the job they've started. Lack of funds may force these zealots to return home early this year. The National Hit Team of Libya cannot fulfill their sacred mission without your help. Your contribution can make the difference between success and failure for these dedicated fanatics. But please, hurry. Time is precious. Life is cheap. Send your donations to the National Hit Team of Libya, PLO Box 4, Tripoli. Remember, a life is an easy thing to waste.
Also in the news tonight, this morning at his office in Washington, Secretary of State Alexander Haig was beaten and robbed by one of his own dangling participles. Aides say Mr. Haig is resting comfortably under grammatical care. And this show business item. Tom Snyder signed off for the final time last night as host of The Tomorrow Show. NBC said they have very specific future plans for Mr. Snyder. A spokesman for the network explained that once Snyder returns from a two-week vacation, he'll be flown to Hollywood, brought out to a Burbank television studio, given a seat behind a desk, and shot. And now, once again, from Highway 6, somewhere in America, is our itinerant correspondent, Rich Hall. Here's his report for this week.
You know, one of the advantages to having these Highway 6 pieces air on national television is it's a little easier to get a ride now that a few people are starting to recognize me.
Anyway, now and then you get picked up by somebody who has their own idea about how to travel cheaply. For instance, this guy. One of his favorite tricks is to pull into a drive-in movie, take in a few films, and then crash there for the night. For me, it's an opportunity to re-examine a vanishing cultural phenomenon, the outdoor theater.
Still pretty easy these days to sneak into drive-ins by using an exit. Just always look out for these things.
Puncture devices. Boy, whoever designed these is a pretty sick individual. I guess some theater owners would do anything to save a few lousy bucks.
Or as far as I'm concerned, this is the way to enjoy a movie. Cheap admission, you don't have a bunch of obnoxious people in the seats behind you, You can stretch out and relax. You can enjoy yourself.
You want to get those feet off of there, pal?
Sorry. Anyway, best of all, it's a great place to spend the night. I don't know about you, Darren, but I'm turning in for the night. The stars up above and that Arnold Ziffel Film Festival to lull me to sleep. I'm going to be signing off. From Highway 6, I'm Rich Hall.
Finally, as most of you probably realize, there are only 5 more days until Christmas. And I know with the tight budgets that a lot of us have this year, we don't want to go through the holidays and end up busting our bank accounts. So here's a money-saving idea that I've used a number of times. Shoplifting. That's right, the old 5-finger discount. It's really easy, too. You just take a big floppy bag into any store, and you find an aisle that's not too crowded, and when you see an item that you like, just kind of slip it, you know, nonchalantly into your bag. And what do you want to do about that, wrapping up that stolen Christmas item? Well, here's what you do. You just go into any store that sells brightly colored wrapping paper and scotch tape and ribbon and stuff like that, and you steal as much as you need. Now, what happens if you get caught and you get thrown in jail? Well, the answer's obvious. If you do, if you're arrested, then there won't be any need for you to buy Christmas gifts. You can just say to your friends, gee, I'm sorry, I couldn't get you a gift this year. I was in a slammer. So, these are my shopping tips. And for the Friday edition, I'd like to wish you all a Merry Christmas. No, one more thing. If any of you want to send me a Christmas card, please send it to the Los Angeles Women's House of Detention. I'll be there till January 15th. Happy New Year. Good night.
This has been the Friday edition with your correspondent, Melanie Chartoff.